In this episode, we talk about frames and frame rates. Again, some pilasters of filmmaking. To explain these concepts, I will take advantage of some visuals from a video editing software, Premiere Pro. What you're seeing here below is called a sequence. In video editing, this is a container of your video and audio material, the area where you actually cut and stitch the clips together to create a video. Keep an eye on it as we carry on with the explanation. So, what is a frame? And here I would actually rephrase the question into, what is a video? A video is essentially a sequence of images, photographs, played one after the other at a certain speed, a speed that gives the illusion of motion. Each of these images is called frame. This is a frame, and another frame, and another, and so on. You get the idea. Now, the speed these images are recorded or played at is called frame rate, and it can be measured in FPS, which stands for frames per second. Let's take this example. We have one man walking from point A to point B. To walk this distance, the man takes 5 seconds. If we film this action at 1 frame per second, then we would only have 5 photos of the man during this period of time. So, 1 second, 1 photo. And now I want to show you an actual video at 1 frame per second. Check it out. I wouldn't definitely win an Oscar for that film. Maybe I would. Let's go back to our walking man, and this time, let's say we want to record him at 8 frames per second. That means that we're adding other 7 images at our previous example in the same amount of time of 1 second. Let's now watch our motocross video at 8 frames per second. As you can see, we can still spot each individual image in it. If we increase the frame rate to 12 frames per second, then we're gonna reproduce that kind of Charlie Chaplin's movies effect, where the character still didn't move as fluid and the movements don't look natural, because still there are not enough frames per second to reproduce a realistic motion. So here comes our bike rider again at 12 frames per second. Up to more or less 10-12 images per second, the human visual system can perceive each image individually, while at higher rates, then we can start seeing those images as motion. And that's when the standard 24 frames per second was introduced. Let's check our video now again at 24 frames per second. Notice the difference. This is again more or less the lowest amount of images that to our eye and brain reproduces emotion as we see it in real life. And this frame rate has been used in probably all the films you have ever watched in your life, apart from a few of them. You're actually watching me too at 24 frames per second right now. Apart from the 24 FPS, in the current days there are other two standard frame rates used around the world, which come from television and cinema. The 25 FPS, which is associated to the PAL system, which stands for phase alternating line. This is the standard broadcast format in Europe, Oceania, Africa, South America, and parts of Asia. And that plays 25 frames per second or multiples of 25. The second is the 30 FPS, to be exact, 29.97 frames per second and multiples of 30. Which this time is associated to the NTSC system, which means National Television System Committee. This is the standard broadcast format in North America. There are cameras out there called high-speed cameras capable of recording thousands of frames per second, like this video. But most of the digital devices today, including smartphones, offer all those frame rates we talked about it above and can record 48, 50, 60, 100, 120 frames per second, which is very useful when you wanna do something in slow motion, for example. Check this video I filmed at 120 frames per second. So when you film at a high frame rate, basically you're filming a lot of images in a tiny amount of time. A feature that allows you to stretch the time during the video editing process, making it run slower than in real life. The opposite effect of slow motion can be achieved with time lapses, where instead you're recording a tiny amount of frames during a long period of time. And in this case, we're making the time go faster than its natural course. In this example, I filmed one frame every 5 seconds of actual time. Here's where mathematics come in useful. Basically, to cover 10 seconds of actual video, in a project at 24 frames per second, I had to leave my camera recording for 20 minutes. Now, I'm sure you're gonna ask, okay, that's all good, but how do I actually choose the frame rate for each project I'm working on? Well, that depends on different factors, and we're gonna talk about it in another episode. More explanatory videos will also come related to motion blur, shutter speed, and slow motion, which are closely related to the frame rate. Well, that's it for today. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn the notifications bell on. If you have 1 minute, I would appreciate if you could leave a comment saying if you have learned something new or if you enjoyed the video. I will see you next week. Thanks for watching and God bless you. Ciao.
Seems all good times come and go your way.